My name is Parshuram Patel. Hope all of you are fine. Today I am going to deliver a lecture on sampling theorem and impulse train sampling. Most of the signals encountered in a nature are continuous in time. But in digital signal processing, the signals are sampled and quantized at discrete time instants and are represented as a sequence of ones and zeros. For examples, signals such as speech signals, ECG and EEG are electrical signals and therefore necessary to perform a conversion to digital representation. So sampling theorem is a process of converting a continuous time signal into a discrete time signal that is analog to digital conversion process. For this, we have to look at the values of the signal at discrete time instants. That is, we have to extract the samples of signals at equispace discrete time instants is known as sampling. This is a continuous time signals, you can see in the diagram, and we have to get the different amplitudes at different time instants. But those samples should be at an equal interval, that is, they should be equispaced in a particular time gap, that is TS, that is called sampling time. The primary concern in sampling is to select the sampling rate, that is the number of samples per second that preserve the information contained in the continuous time signal. So you can see in the diagram, this is a continuous time signals, and if we will use the impulse signal which is present at a particular instant and absent everywhere, so we will multiply this continuous time signal by a shifted impulse at different time instants, 0 TS, 2 TS, 3 TS, so we will get the value at that place of continuous signal. So these are the samples. The samples at minus TS, at 0, at TS, at 2 TS and 3 TS. These are different samples and these are the time instants. These time instants are equispaced discrete time instants and these are different samples. So time interval between two subsequent samples is called the sampling interval. That is the sampling period and that is the fundamental period. So this theorem is exploited in many places like moving pictures, pattern recognition, speech recognition, biometric identification, digital watermarking and surveillance system. There are huge applications of sampling theorem in daily life. So what is the process of sampling? First step is to discretize the sequence from continuous to discrete time. Now omega s is the angular sampling frequency, that is the 2 pi upon ts, and ts is the sampling period. If a signal is band limited signal, band limited means a signal which is present for a particular frequency range. If we will take the Fourier transform sequence and that is present for a particular time range, particular frequency range, then that signal is known as band limited signal. Here you can see the definition. A signal is band limited if its Fourier transform is zero outside a finite band of frequencies. So if the samples are taken sufficiently close together means we are considering more number of samples. If we have to consider more number of samples, then TS should be reduced. So FS and omega S will be larger frequency present in the signal. Then the samples uniquely specify the signals. We can reconstruct it perfectly. This is known as sampling theorem. Means let ST be a band limited signal whose Fourier transform, that is x of j omega equal to 0 for magnitude of omega greater than omega m. Means frequency domain response, that is transform of this sequence ST is present for minus omega m to omega m. Elsewhere it is 0. Then ST is uniquely determined by its samples at different time instants, that is NTS. This is the value of samples at different time instants where n can be 0 plus minus, that is integer multiple of TS. So for sampling purpose, omega s, that is the sampling rate, sampling frequency must be greater than twice the frequency of message signal, that is frequency of band limited signal. So omega s greater than 2 omega m. So omega s, and where omega s is equal to 2 pi upon ts. So this is the sampling theorem. Hope you have understood. For further queries, you can write me on Google Class. Thank you. Thank you.